You slimy shapeshifter! Hello, you're the one ruining the prince's plans. Besides, don't you think I look a lot better in this outfit than you? Is that shovel for putting on makeup? I am like so talented. I can look like anybody. Check this.
Oh.
Or this.
Who's that?
Maybe that was me. But this is the real me. Breathtaking, Blue.
I like the last one better.
You stink!
What did you do with Pino?
You mean the prince didn't tell you? Then again, why would he tell a stupid human? Either way, you're not getting past me.
You got it all wrong. I'm not taking the fall for your adventures.
After I beat you, I'll change back and take all the cake I can eat.
Boss fight time. Gotta catch me first. Shit. it sounds like it. This might be the entire battle. Hello?
Yo.
I got my butt kicked.
By Cream?
Yep.
Figured as much. Yeah, she's that one boss of the game. Took me a while to figure out how to fight her.
Well, you didn't see... by the way, how's the stream quality? Is it a slideshow or is it actually watchable?
It's actually watchable.
Good. That means I did it right.
And also, I almost, the other day, won a tournament set in Smash 4.
Oh, cool.
Like, we were tied on matches because he won the first round in that match set, I won the second, and it was a last stock situation on the third.
Ooh.
The second match, even the first stock of the third, it just... Kirby's up B Meteor. And I burst out laughing because I did not expect that to work as well as it did, but apparently my opponent was very aggressive, and I had the counter-aggressive measures.
Like, what took you so long?
Why can't I skip this cutscene? I've seen it three
times.
You
make me sick, you slimy shapeshifter!
Okay, so yeah, regarding Cream, you'll mainly want to be running away from her until you get a chance to attack her, and then continue running away from her.
So basically the same kiting I was doing.
I am like so talented. I can look like anybody.
Yeah.
Well, it's a good thing I've got 50% damage reduction on my head now.
Oh.
Yep. And also, hang on, let me think.
Who's that?
You just fell off the ground.
No, I didn't fall off it. I ran off.
While getting to the boss ground. Okay, then.
What did you do with Pino? You
mean the want to be running from... And you'll... It is possible for her to catch up with you with an attack, but that just mix up jumps.
That's what healing
you feel you need. Yeah, you also need to mix in jumps to your evasive maneuvers whenever you feel the need to.
And I need to make sure I jump when I hear the word Firestorm.
Or you can do the front slash or pretty missile, whichever one you have.
I don't think I have any of those.
The front slash, yeah, you have that. It's the guard dash and then circle. Yeah, that gives you invincibility frames. The front slash is your best friend in this boss fight. And actually, if you had the pretty missile, the upgrade to the front slash, that would be even better.
When did she get the great spin attack?
Oh, the great spin attack?
Yeah, from Wind Waker.
Firestorm!
Nope, I didn't jump.
You mean the...
The whirlwind attack.
Yeah.
Dang it.
You didn't just die again.
Oh no, it's way too early. I just fell off the arena.
Good job. But yeah, there will be a big plot point that you've actually kind of already figured out. But there's gonna be something a bit more to it.
What, that Perrin is actually the prince? I figured that one would make you laugh.
Okay, just let me ask, are you serious about that guess, or...?
That was a gag guess. Perrin is not the prince, even I know that.
Okay, well, I'm just gonna go ahead and shoot that down now, because, yeah, that's wrong. But Yeah, there is gonna be something, and I'll point it out when it comes time. Also, just run when she says you're getting on my nerves. You don't even have to. Guard dash helps, but you don't even have to do it. Just run.
She makes the same sound that I do when I jump.
And it helps to try and keep the camera on her as much as possible.
Yeah, that much I noticed too. I keep thinking dodge is square. Dodge is not square, I have dodge set to triangle.
Why do you have it set to the Y button?
Because I'm thinking of it like a PS2, not an Xbox.
Huh.
Oh, she's made her groans. Time to eat.
I remember this boss took me quite a few tries until I found out that running away from her was the best strategy. I didn't even need the nightcap.
Oh, hey, a money. I must have killed a fake or something.
A money? I thought that the clones were invincible. Are they not?
Well, I keep getting money. Oh, I bet it's because of the monkey.
Maybe. Oh, wow, you actually did destroy one of the clones. I guess they're not as invincible as I thought. Why aren't you using the front slash?
Because I got three people, I gotta dodge.
But it gives you invincibility frames! Seriously! That's like one of the best things to use in this game! It causes so much damage, too!
Well, things seem to have calmed down.
Oh wow, she got rid of a clone.
I've been doing it, yes.
And now they're back. Yeah, when she says Firestorm, just front slash and you'll invincibility frame right through it. Come on, please. Although this is kind of surreal, seeing someone fight a boss and actually get close to succeeding without using front slash.
Now, did we decide which element was the right one?
I don't think so. Which element are you currently using? You're not using any of the elements.
Okay, I tried dodging through the firestorm, it did not stop the effect.
Oh, I said dodge and front slash, not just dodge. It doesn't work that well if you just dodge. All the way back.
Of course.
Oh, you beat her!
Yes, I did.
So yeah, watch this cutscene and tell me if you see... No, tell me anything that seems suspicious.
Where's Pino? But why? You're human. Why would you help a monster? I don't get it.
There's nothing to get. These monsters are my friends.
I didn't know humans could care.
The prince isn't rebuilding a phantom kingdom. What does he really want?
You're wrong. The real prince would never. Ah! But why?
You! Why did you do that?
She served her purpose. Now my plan begins in earnest.
What plan?
If you want to save Pino, come to Eggplant Caverns. I'll be waiting for you.
Hey!
So?
That's not the real prince.
And anything else you notice that's suspicious?
I would say that's Pino's brother in disguise, but that would be obvious. So of course that's going to be the answer.
I was just going to point out the fact that even though Pino seems to be captured, why was she watching the battle? Or why was she right there and going with the prince?
What are you doing here?
Pino is
You're trying to hide things.
That's what? Not good. This is the Phantom Stronghold, the most dangerous place in this world.
But I have to save her.
Of course you do.
Okay, wish me luck.
No turning back.
Oh, point of no return, eh?
No, it's not a point of no return.
Wasn't specifying it for Perrin.
What is that supposed to mean?
Are you familiar with the phrase crossing the Rubicon?
No.
When Caesar was doing his campaigns in Rome, he reached the point where he absolutely had to continue, even though he knew it was a bad idea.
Oh, that's why you said it. No turning back. Okay.
Am I taking water damage or what?
Yeah, that's... well, in a sense, water damage. You do need to be wary of the water that lines the walls. In fact, it's probably just energy, but it's treated as... Let's go with lava damage. Yeah, it's damage that can't really be negated unless the bow... unless it counts as a trap, in which case the bow would be able to do it, but I don't think it does. So yeah, you're in the final world right now, but you're still a good deal before being done with the game.
Fair enough. Uh-huh.
Namely because I'd like you to do the bonus stuff, which we'll cover in a bit. Also, energy ghosts, yay!
Well, this is certainly an elevator that's happening.
There are some puzzles. Don't tell me you put the... Oh no, you did the same mistake I made. Wait, it can be pushed out? The crate can be pushed out of the hole.
Hey, that caught me by surprise.
That is new to
too.
Me.
Delicious junk.
I thought that was... That screwed me over and I'd have to come back for the... I see you had a lot of fun with this elevator puzzle. Om nom nom. You kind of sound like, do you sound like Rom when saying that? I'm not sure, actually. Oh, by the way, did you see the cracked wall?
No, I missed it.
Ah. I've noticed you've been missing a lot of the cracked walls in this game. So let's just check my stream delay real quick. 91 seconds is the latency to broadcaster. Latency to encoder is 96 seconds, and the broadcaster just became 100 seconds. But at the very least, you have zero skipped frames.
I have dropped 263 frames. That is half of a percent.
Well, in that case, I retract my performance statement. Oh, it's resetting. It's resetting the stream for me. Wait, now that I think about it. Is this part of the main... Is this a remix of the main thing, or... One of the main things? Did you really forget how to activate shock crystals in this game?
I didn't recognize them as shock crystals at first.
Money. Well, I never knew that. I took that. So, that platform with tracks. No, I don't remember doing that. Oh man, Pakota, we're actually doing platforming.
Much to my consternation, yes.
Whoa, her hat disappeared for a moment. I've never seen that happen in
the
PSP version. No, I know for a fact it didn't happen in the PSP version. You see the fun of the shock parts.
Actually, I'm just using the shock parts because I had to use them earlier.
Well, the thing about it is the fire parts burn the opponent and cause damage over time, as could be expected. The shock parts shock them for a bit and slow them down temporarily. The front and the ice parts freeze the opponent for less time than the amount of time that the shock parts shock effect slow down lasts, but still, freezing the opponent, very useful. So I've been experimenting around for a little bit.
Dirty.
I don't know what happens if you ignore those phantoms.
This is amazing!
That was corny, Pakota.
Corns! My corns!
Might be tempting to get a platform after that. Maybe, we'll see.
You didn't think of Mr. Green?
No.
What was that?
They're talking Clue. Or Cluedos, call it.
And you really don't like grilling the junk off of enemies, do you?
I don't usually think of that as the thing.
Well, let's just say you're getting a lot less junk than you really could be getting. blade.
I'm riding a turtle.
Thank you.
I'm riding a turtle.
That guy just nailed that guy just down the air with
it. I'm riding a turtle.
And there's a highlight.
What, riding on a turtle?
Along with your singing.
Oh, I was belting it in the basement at work today.
Really?
Yeah.
And you've made it to the end of that level.
Yay!
A ducky!
Chucky gave Chucky the duck. And on that note, I need to take a quick break and get something to drink, because I'm thirsty.
Okay. I'm gonna get popcorn myself.
It is an honor, but I cannot let you pass.
I am in a hurry.
Oh, hey, Motoro.
Please stand aside.
I'd love to, but I don't want to.
You leave me no choice.
I am very curious as to what Cat Dad's doing here. Ha!
You should have gone into retirement.
Not while I can still be useful.
Yeah.
Your friends would not approve of your plans.
Huh? You figured it out? No matter. Even you, the legendary warrior, can't stop me now. She's here.
We will finish this later.
Let's go, Yumiko. And now let's go! Dude looks like Poopoo. I like him.
I'm back with popcorn.
Ooh, popcorn.
And I think I need to change my headphones because I just got a battery low. What'd you say after I said I'm back with popcorn?
Popcorn.
Popcorn.
The kidney.
Popcorn is good. Although perhaps I should be a bit more careful with how frequently I eat it during streams.
Are you eating the pre-bagged stuff, or are you eating fresh popped?
Pre-bagged.
You gotta get the fresh stuff, man. Get some fresh.
I mean Orville Redenbacher.
No, you gotta get fresh stuff, man.
Yeah, I agree, but
get yourself an air popper.
We had a popcorn popper once, but it was very loud.
They tend to be, yes.
And I think there's one certain reason, I forget exactly why we got rid of it. Also, you just ran on the nothing. On the wall of nothing. You certainly had a fun time leaving that enemy suspended in animation in air.
I think I might be in trouble.
You're still using level 3 drills, you gotta just go with the regular drill attack.
Take
You just died.
Yes, I did.
At least Game Over sent you to the beginning of the room.
Yes, as I found out. Unfortunately, I had more health when I came into this room than I do now. Oh, that's actually helpful.
Huh?
Shortcake.
Can you use that right now or save it for later?
I'm gonna save it for later.
You guys should see a heal point anytime soon. Right? Gotcha. You finally are breaking that wall.
Well, I have to see them before I can know they're there, yeah?
Well, haven't you actually... You mean tell me you haven't seen any of them?
It's hard for me to see them half the time. Oh. Now I use a short cake. That was brilliant.
Oh, it's brilliant.
You'll see it.
It's a good bag of popcorn.
I've never met a bag of popcorn I didn't like.
And I see that you just... The invincibility frames from grabbing the drill didn't... I mean, the dirt... From drilling up the dirt didn't really save you there from the cannonball.
You get invincibility frames for that?
Yeah.
Man, this game just gives invincibility frames out like candy, doesn't it?
Yeah, you're not using them. I mean, I guess I can kind of... If this was Kirby, I would applaud that, but it's not.
Okay. Now for the $32 question, how do I drill through these blocks that are on the other side of the wall?
You have to time your charge of starting the drill, and you just drill them. If you do the standard drill instead of the full drill charge, you'll stay in place so that you can just drill it as you pass.
I'm close enough to drill them as I pass?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, but not with the drill dash. The regular, you know, the charge attack.
Yeah, I know what you're referring to. It's just I'm having a hard time believing that I'm close enough to do that.
Well, it works.
Oh, I see. You have to drill down. Okay. Now it makes sense. Put on the parts of the train.
Oh, I can help bring the fire. Face attack. How did that pull up and burn?
She wasn't actually wearing the ice box.
You just drilled in a circle.
See, now that I understand what I'm actually supposed to be doing with these columns, it's easy. It's just a matter of understanding what I'm supposed to be doing.
Right.
I thought I was supposed to be drilling the rocks themselves.
No.
Apparently, bugs don't like ice.
Really?
Also healing spot, of course, because why not?
That's better. Gee, it would be nice if I could make my jumps.
Platforming is fun, isn't it?
Especially in 3D.
Especially when you don't have anything like a double jump or anything. Look at you, Mario.
Quidditch.
What makes you say that?
Well, why else would I have been? Why else would I have said Quidditch?
Oh, sorry, I didn't even notice that.
Hey, Maiku Wadaharu. Yeah, the Steam achievements for this game are basically advance the plot a little, and then advance the plot a little more, and then advance the plot a little more.
Isn't there anything else? There should be, like, others that aren't just advancing the plot.
There are others that aren't just advancing the plot, but I've got most of the ones of those that I want to get. So everything else for this game from here on out is basically advance the plot a little. Hello.
Well, you are really close to the end. At the same time.
Just ignore the room full of piggy banks.
No climbing the ladder could be so loud. Indeed.
This is like the perfect game for me to play though, because it pretends to be a rhythm game.
And you like rhythm games?
I'm good with music in general. It's like you missed it, but at the start of the stage I was actually counting out the rhythm of the music. Oh hey, there's a C rank.
Oh, now you're at this part. Okay, so after you give the thing to the monster. This is gonna be a fun part. Fun series of events. Basically, huge plot dub incoming.
Okay. Does it have anything to do with the fact that Buku's the pretend prince of the phantoms?
Maybe.
Okay.
Okay.
should play Necrodancer before I go to bed. Maybe just a round of it.
Play what?
Crypt of the Necrodancer.
Oh, yeah. My game.
This place is beautiful. Wow. What's this? We can't get through with this thing in the way.
There's gotta be some way to get through.
You're in the topaz path.
Switches?
Yep.
I don't think it's a switch.
What should I do?
Take a look around and see what you can find. Pino must be somewhere ahead.
Okay.
So I know you clearly saw him holding that remote.
What remote?
You know, the one that he pressed to close the door, even though he seems to be trying to hide something.
Oh, that remote. No, I'm sure I didn't see it either.
Really? So you have to get through. Better do some drilling.
Go!
Yeah. Okay. So that's what I want. Let's see, that lit up. Looks like Scorpio and Libra. No, that's not Scorpio. It's definitely Libra.
So, do you think this is a good idea?
Of course not. But I have to do it anyway. Let's see, that's Sagittarius and Capricorn. It has to be Capricorn because it's right after Sagittarius.
Oh,
these two are Pisces and Aries. I know, but I just like keeping track. This one is going to light up Gemini and Cancer.
Dakota, there's no puzzle in this. It's just drilling the four platforms really pillars.
I know, but I like recognizing.
What?
No. Oh. I am too late.
Time has come at last.
What?
Tokarone's revival has begun.
Tokarone?
Hooray, you Dungu!
I told you about him. He's the great dragon.
But then again, so did I when I played this game. Ago.
You mean the dragon imprisoned with this drill?
Yes. The one trapped by a human hero and a monster warrior. That was your grandfather, and this monster here.
My grandpa? The hero? And Motaro? You were the monster warrior?
But it is to you, descendant of the courageous hero, that I owe my success.
What are you talking about?
This.
Oh my gosh, Buku is the prince of the phantoms.
The princess Buku in disguise. He fooled all of us, monsters and phantoms.
All went as planned. The only thing that can break the crystal imprisoning Tokarone is that drill. And I needed you to wield it.
So did you expect to be correct, or?
Fighting his servants.
I guessed it a while back.
So you could save him from his
kidnappers.
Yeah. It was all
Please
part
of don't
his
tell
plan.
Me it was because of my hinting.
Even saving Pino from the dog? And meeting the other monsters?
The game didn't exactly try to hide.
It was all
okay, so I wasn't too obvious.
Strong, so I had you fight.
Still, we don't know Cuckoo's motives right now.
But the charade
but we know his goal.
Why are you doing this?
Why?
Yep. And
to
I'll be right
revenge
back.
On humankind.
On us? What
did we ever do
Enough
to you?
Enough talk! Togaron is back. There is something I must do.
I'm half expecting him to call Togaron father.
Are powerless to stop me. Just sit back and watch.
Wait!
He went inside. That is where Togaron is imprisoned.
We have to go stop him. I'm just going to let you go. What's
so,
this all about?
What soundboard command would be appropriate here.
I didn't want to hurt you, but you leave me no choice. Get her, Giga!
Right now, I'm guessing.
Are you getting beaten up by Giga?
Punch her, Giga!
Yep, you're getting beaten up by Giga. Just by hearing Giga, I can tell. Here's the tip. After you drill away the rocks, the front slash is your best friend.
Go! Hiya! Da!
Punch her, Giga!
Get her, Giga!
It would be nice if I could jump while charging.
Yeah. But this isn't strictly a platformer, it's an action RPG. Oh wow, I'm not sure if I've ever seen him do the fireball before. I might have, but just forgotten, but... Or that spark attack. I've seen him do shockwave, but... Huh.
I should have bought me some healing, because this is a train wreck.
Oh yeah, you don't even have the Dragon Flame either, the upgrade to the Pretty Missile, which I'm pretty sure is available at this point in time. Yeah, after this battle, whether you win or lose, go head back to the town.
Okay.
But yeah, the dragon, the higher upgraded the front slash gets, the more invincibility frames and power and range you get out of it, so it's well worth it. Namely because she delays the attack a bit more each time when the delay counts as invincibility frames, and that doesn't even make it harder to anyone. In fact, if anything, it makes it easier.
And I'm Gver.
You died?
I died.
Okay, on to the town. Oh wow, you got comboed.
It will not let me go.
It won't?
There is a door here. It will not let me go through.
You should just be able to exit from the pause menu.
Oh, okay. Now, I'm not gonna have to go through that first part again, am I?
No, you won't have to go back through the first part.
Yay.
At least I'm pretty sure it autosaves, because I remember that the entrances to the bonus levels autosave after you've beaten them once, even if you haven't cleared the level yet. So, I'm pretty sure it's the same for boss battles. At least no, you don't have to go through that and first starting thing on after you've beaten the boss, but I'm pretty sure it applies to before you've beaten the boss as well. Pecky seems to be gone.
Can't buy the
vamp
kit yet.
Oh wow, you... huh.
So I guess I'll try to do the other thing then.
Yeah, maybe you should. Honestly, I would suggest you do a tiny bit of grinding until you can buy the vamp kit and upgrade it a bit. That's
what I'm intending on doing.
What?
That's what I intend to do for right now.
Okay.
Because I still have Radish Woods Serpent Road to figure out.
Wait, did you talk to Cylinder?
Oh, the bomb guy, no.
You need to talk to him to get the dragon's
plan. Every time I try to light these torches, I break them instead.
Okay. Here's a suggestion. Maybe in order to actually see the torches, you should turn off the stream, but...
I can see the torches. I can see the torches now. It's just every time I try to light them, where I stand, I break them. Like, once in a blue moon, I will light a torch. If you
need to use the dragon's flame.
That's actually required.
Okay, well, the pretty missile, or whatever you have at the time, but Dragon's Flame, man. Since you've broken torches, head back to at least get the Dragon's Flame from Cylinder. This is a good time to do so. It's the best front slash in the game.
And torch burn. But I got four of them lit this time. If I didn't have to go to the sign to turn the torches off before I could light them, this would be a little easier.
You could just try from the side. And the Dragon's Flame does cover, its shockwave does cover, like, a lot of the torches when you try to do it from the side, so it's a lot easier.
It's Ew.
And yet you seem very, very insistent on doing this with the Pretty Missile.
Because I can do it now, and if I buy the Pretty Missile now, I'm not gonna have enough for the man.
You mean the dragon part. Whatever. And fair enough.
Gotcha!
6, 7, one more. Alright, let's do this. I missed. No, they're all lit.
Yeah. Go.
Oh yeah, I have to talk to the dude again. Alright, new dungeon time, Serpent Road.
Yay. So is this the first of the reverse dungeons?
This will be the second one that I've done. I did the
The one in Potato Rooms.
Yeah, I did that one already.
Okay. So you probably noticed that, like I said, reverse levels are, in terms of basic structure, they're reversed versions of the main levels. But they do have different enemy positions in. Yeah. Enough to warrant them at least being different levels, and they are more difficult.
Fair enough. On my level. And now, Yumiko, let's go for a swim.
Yay!
Actually, it occurs to me that this would be better. I would be better suited by wearing the ice parts and monkey hat. Because with the ice parts, I can freeze the ice.
I just thought about that. Yes, you can.
At least in theory.
You can.
Okay, how do I make it happen reliably?
Okay, I see. You need... Oh, do you even have that ability yet? Okay, so jump and do a cyclone attack real quick.
Or I could just do the pretty missile again.
And that did it?
That did it.
Okay, well, there's another attack that works. It's a jump and then cyclone attack downward if you have that ability from Cylinder. I forget what it's called, but it's basically a downward stab, a downward drill attack. And it works. It works wonders, and so front smash works. That should make it a lot easier to deal with the fish. I'm saying that for myself.
You've never tried that?
I've always used the downward drill attack that I'm telling you about.
Oh, by the way, I didn't actually have to freeze it.
You didn't?
No, there was a switch that made minions.
Oh, well. Freezing things is still fun and useful. And they wouldn't give you the ability to freeze water if they didn't intend for you to use it.
Yeah, that's true.
You can choose your own way to cross.
Very easily destroying the torches outside the dungeon, and now I can't destroy a torch to save my life.
Funny how that works, huh?
Yeah.
actually am going to quickly bust out the N64.
Go replace some GoldenEye?
I do not have that. So, no. I'm gonna play either Super Smash Brothers or. What else do I have?
Rail Shooter.
Dark Pokemon 64.
I also have Hey You Pikachu, but unfortunately, right now, I can't play that. Because VRU unit. I'm gonna ask for it for my birthday, though. Which comes April 28th.
April 28th, got it.
After the release of the Switch, which I'm not gonna ask for the Switch for my birthday for two reasons. One, I know that even if it was on my list, my parents wouldn't get it from me because of how expensive it is. I mean, it was a nice and it was a very kind gesture on Dad's part to surprisingly get me a Wii U 2 years ago so I could practice for the Smash tournament, the first one that I went to. But that was situational, and yeah, that's not gonna happen again. So I'm getting the Switch on my own this time.
Fire-breathing pumpkins. Because why not?
It's not that my parents are. Even if they don't give me what I want, because that would be a flat-out lie if I said that. It's more that they've been very nice to me. I'm gonna take care of this myself.
Woo.
Okay, gonna put a
now. I'm missing drilly walls. I know, because there were drilly walls on the way in.
Oh, whoops, I just realized Wario World is still in the now unplugged GameCube. Whatever.
That's always fun times.
Yeah, I'm still geeking out looking at this thing. I still can't believe I actually have one. Thank you for this one. This will be a fun time or a half. Okay. When I get more games. And even now it's still a fun time or a half. Currently, my favorite game for it is Super Smash Brothers. Although...
I got a bookshelf.
You got a bookshelf! Do some reading. I don't know.
Actually, I probably will read after the stream tonight.
Read yourself to sleep?
Maybe not quite that, but I will do some reading. Kilometer Path. If you want the door to open, speak the password. I don't know the password.
Okay, what is it asking for the password?
I do not know, but it's not letting me back out of the thing, because I always forget that this is the dude that you'll want to talk to last.
Alright, grabbing the rail shooter. I'll have Dark Demario 64.
The password is L, the first part is to my front and side.
I just realized on the back of the Star Fox 64 card, $4, and some other strange marking.
Yes, we're just
one strange marking on the back.
Picardia.
Okay,
I believe S P. I. L. L. The password is spill.
Hey, Picada.
It's not spill.
You wanna know something funny that I just saw on the back of this N64 cartridge on the caution thing?
What?
One of the caution things is do not blow on the edge connector or touch with fingers. About that. I'm pretty sure everyone who owns a Nintendo 64 or any Nintendo console or any cartridge console has broken that rule in their life. Imagine, you know, the blowing into cartridges thing. So that's kind of funny.
Oh, I bet. I don't know what's going on here. There we go, capital letters. Alright, kilometer path, let's go.
Okay, let's see if I can deal with fighter pilot controls. Need to find and up, figure out what upscale I need to be able to use the S64 and GameCube on the Hog.
It's not that you need an upscaler for it, it's just that, you need to convince it to use a composite. And it could be that it just doesn't know how to handle 480i.
What do you think an upscaler would work?
I think what I have, RCA hub would work best for you.
RCA. After the stream, you'll send me some.
After the stream, I'll. Yeah, after the stream, I'll send you more details.
Okay, yeah.
Kind of.
That sounds cool. Thank you.
Spoiter!
Spoiter!
Hey, you're not a tap dancing spoiter. No.
Okay, so which path should I take here in Corneria? Hard path or easy path? Okay, Granga or Star Fox 1 first boss?
No, I can't answer that for you. Flip a coin.
Eh, I'll just take the hard path in that case.
Delicious.
Man, I am good at steering this thing, and by that I mean absolutely terrible. I'm way better with keyboard controls. How have I not lost one of my wings yet?
You're not playing on expert. That's why you haven't lost a wing yet.
Oh yeah, in expert mode, all hits are one hit, lose wings, right?
Not all hits, but enough of them to where it feels like.
Well, yeah, any solid collisions.
Yeah, basically any impact with the ground on the wing side will break your wing.
Four walls.
Corneria, yes. Future stages, I'm not quite so sure about. I never actually had expert mode for myself.
Why did I not go for the bomb?
Slow moving lasers!
Oh, well, I'm still at full health, okay, so although.
Hitting the laser well does not kill me or anything. It just ends. 5 points damage! I need 310 junk to bring the vampire hack up to level 4.
I just used a bomb accidentally. Why did I do that? I'm at 4 bombs.
And in the words of Rowan, Metrol is better to use a bomb than to use a bomb.
But on nothing? When I wasn't in danger at all? There was absolutely nothing to hurt me. Besides, I've got health, so... And bombs don't give you invincibility, so they're not as foolproof as. Besides, they don't even work on bosses.
They work on a couple bosses, but those bosses are specifically designed for bosses.
I'd like to know which bosses. Well, except for
Zonas.
Zonas one. Which bosses those are? Well,
technically, also Aquas.
Well, you get the idea. Also, do charge jets work on bosses, or do they just not do any difference?
I don't believe they will lock on, but if you manage to hit a boss with a charge shot.
But yeah, bombs don't seem to work on the attack barrier. But that's fine. Ow. Never thought I'd say that.
Oh joy, two berserkers and a gunner. Let's get rid of the gunner.
I can play Star Fox 64 amazingly with keyboard controls, but I really need to get used to them with regular controls. Just boosting. I'll admit, boosting and breaking is a lot awkward with the button placements for me. And we're on to Sector Y.
Sector Y's a fun.
Yeah, normally I like to just go on to media though, but. Let's see if I can get 100 hits here.
I got chocolate and a bunch of spiders.
Or rather, a certain enough, like, I think, 85 hits maybe, and then, like, at least before the boss. I think that can also work.
What's the point of putting up a barrier system if I can just drill through it? I don't even get junk for that, it's just money.
Okay, so I need to down and boost to do a somersault. I tried the boost, and I ended up falling. See, that's what I mean when I say that the button placements are a bit awkward for me to get used to. Ugh.
Was the silliest placement of four dogs ever. And our reward is the phonograph. So let's turn in these spoils. Chivos. All right, let's go get the van kit because I can afford it.
There's one Shogun Warrior down.
Well, the good news is that I only need to get 100 more, I only need to get 100 more jump to afford the other thing. Dragon Slayer. Whoa, this sword is huge. Why did you have it anyway? I have a sword. What am I supposed to do with a sword?
Sword?
A sword. What am I supposed to do with a sword?
Wait, what? I don't remember that. Okay, so I don't remember that part, but I believe that has something to do with the bonus character you get on a New Game Plus. And it, by a New Game Plus, I mean you have to beat the game actually a few times to play as her. Okay, there's the second Shogun Warrior down. And Shogun himself.
Anyway, it's time to grind up more junk. I'm trying to remember where the good spot for that was.
I never use bombs when they will actually benefit me. I only use bombs when they are a waste. Because I can't seem to not accidentally use them. And I don't know what would be good situations to use them otherwise. But the only times I've ever used bombs playing on an actual N64 are accidental button presses.
A nice fluffy bed. Thank you. So now that I'm in town, I keep getting I sense I still have something to do. And it's not letting me leave. Probably has something to do with that sword.
Maybe give it to...
No, this one of it. I got an alchemy book. What am I supposed to do with that?
Going to the ship was a bad idea, Shogun. Okay, so how are my teammates doing?
They're doing dead.
No, none of them are dead yet. Now let's also see how many hits I got. Yeah, I didn't get enough.
I got a manga!
Oh wow, you got an alka- I really... You're finding things I've never been able to
choco
find,
cake.
I didn't know about.
What am I doing with the choco cake?
Alfalfa is not doing too good, but I'm up to Katina.
So this all started from an empty mystery bag.
Really?
Yeah, inside the empty mystery bag was a diamond. I traded the diamond for the Dragon Slayer for an alchemy book, the alchemy book for a manga for a cake, and the cake is now for rump steak. I bet I know who gets this. Question is, where is he?
I really don't remember this. I don't remember this! I really don't remember this sequence! Oh, wait! This must be the training sequence I couldn't figure out how to get to work.
Where is Doggy? Doggy!
You figured out the trading sequence.
I didn't figure it out so much as I stumbled on it.
Okay, what was the first step again? How did you trigger it?
An empty mystery bag.
But I thought the trading sequence was only available in New Game Plus. In fact, it even said that a side quest unlocked at the end when I beat it. But, what? Well, whatever. Cantina, here we go.
I sense I still have something to do. You know, this whole mess with the trading sequence started because I can't leave town. The game won't let me leave town until I finish this.
Oh boy.
So the dog gave me a bunch of gold coins.
Oops, sorry, Bill.
Coin depicting royalty from somewhere.
Sorry, I'm just... I just nearly collided with a Quinarian fighter.
Got wallpaper, gas mask manga. You could use the desk in parents' house to change desktop wallpaper. Really? Well, that's better than nothing anyway, and I bet I can leave town now that I've done that.
Oh, there's the mothership.
Yay, I can leave.
Oh my gosh, I think that really is the bonus character in the manga.
Let's see, bats hide away, don't want to mess with that right now.
It's the mothership.
Dragon's back. Can't remember where the monster dispenser was. I think it was Spinach Caverns too. Let's check out Tumultuous Cave. What's your puzzle? Evidently, that's not it. Okay. And what's your deal? If you wish to pass, place your feet on my head.
I'm taking care not to kill any Quinarian fighters so that I can try and get the special message from Bill.
You're worthy, you may pass. Well, that was a fairly straightforward puzzle once he gave me the box. Pimento Mountain Dragon's Back.
And I come completely.
Throw myself off the mountain because why not? Oh, it's not gonna let me do that, okay.
I lost a wing and my laser power-up, but at least I took out the core.
I keep losing my footing. This first step is a Lulu.
Okay, I should get the special message from Bill in the back and I kill the command fighter. Mission accomplished, yay! So you don't have to destroy all the hatches in order for the... Yes! I got it!
Yes, he got it. Meanwhile, I keep losing my foot. There we go, that was easier. That was cool.
If you're just careful about that, then... course you'll get that. And now it's on to my favorite level in the game, Solar.
How did I know?
But I love this level.
How did I know it was going to be Solar that you would like?
Probably because you've seen my Star Fox 64 boss run, maybe?
I actually have not seen that.
Oh, wow. That's on my old channel, so... Makes sense.
That.
I don't know if I'll be able to. Doesn't make it back. Neither does he. Yeah, the lower you fly in this level, the
more damage you take.
Yeah. Thankfully, there's health pickups aplenty. But at the same time. Thank you for the laser upgrade, Bill. I needed that. Now I've got twin lasers to replace one of my lasers. Well, yeah, I kind of lost one of my wings taking out the mothership core in the last stage.
Well, that was certainly a nice float.
And I hit a checkpoint.
I got a platinum medal for some reason.
Yay, platinum medals. There's 11 in the game, and once you get all of them, there's something special in store for you.
Why do I not like the way you said that?
Well, it's actually something really good, and I'd recommend, I'll help you find them, later on. Because there is something you'll want, trust me.
Meanwhile, jump.
So yeah, I am planning at some point to play Star Fox 64 on my channel, but I kinda now want to play it instead of using an emulator for the keyboard controls. I want to get used to the N64 controls.
They are something different.
Ah yeah, the Fly Star. Okay, figuring out how to dodge that's gonna be fun. And now for the head.
Now to fall off the cliff because it's ice.
remember having a lot of fun with this game on an emulator, you know.
For real.
This is one of my more favorite non-Toho schmucks out there. Okay, so he's invincible and does that. Oh! I just lost my wing to the lava. How am I supposed to get over that then?
Seem to be going the wrong way.
Yeah, that is a fun level. Although normally my teammates end up taking a lot of damage from it.
Oh yay, that's fun, I fell off the cliff again.
And at the very least, Solar doesn't have a separate mission that you have to go through to get the mission accomplished. It's just single.
Okay, that was funny. I got knocked by a cannonball back onto the human pad.
Yeah, this is a pretty tricky level. Hey, mine's missing a wing. So what? I don't know why you're complaining. Slippy's surprisingly doing the best out of all of us. Falco and Peppy are almost in the yellow, almost in the red.
They're in the yellow, almost in the yellow.
And he's only just barely left the blue, in terms of health. Okay, on to Macbeth. Oh, Landmaster stage.
Hey, the Landmaster's actually pretty fun.
not to me. I hate the Landmaster. A good
deal.
Well,
that sounds like a you problem.
Just occurred to me, I'm still streaming.
You just realized that?
Well, it's 10 o'clock now.
Uh-huh.
And I don't really have a good place to stop right this second.
I hate it, Slip. Thanks for asking. Sorry, Falco. Landing on a train. On a moving train apparently hurts me. Because, you know, that's a thing.
Oh boy, getting knocked off the cliff by their fire breath.
Oh. Step on the gas! Yes, please, step on the gas! I hit the 8 switches. I'm off to area 6.
Congratulations.
Step on the gas! Yeah! That is a very, very, very satisfying set of explosions.
It always is.
I mean, a train carrying a bunch of weapons just crashed into its factory. Yeah. That's gotta be satisfying.
Gee, it would be nice if I knew where I was going right now.
Oh man, Falco is almost dead. He's probably gonna die at Area 6. Oh, but he's got a bit more health now. Peppy's doing a bit better, but Falco's kinda in the same state as he was at the end of Solar, meaning I'd better be careful.
You going for medals?
No, not right now. I'm just going for beating the game. I'm not good enough for... I've been able to get the Fortuna medal.
Well, yeah, but I can get the Fortuna medal.
Yeah, but not right now. I can't even get the Fortuna medal. So it's, And I'm just going for beating game. Beating levels. You know, all that jazz.
All that jazz.
So he's made it... So, Tristan made it to Titania, but not quite, past Bolse. He took the easy path. Okay, here we go. Area 6. Lasers or blue lasers right now. Came in here, no problem. We got problems!
Came in here, I already died.
I like how... Oh no, I have single lasers right now.
Came in here, they're killing us with inferior weapons, over. To the trap.
Ah, Falco's down! No!
The lever seems stuck. Minecart, now I'm in the minecart. Wish I could remember.
Oh, why didn't I get the lasers? Gotta tell me why I didn't get the lasers.
Because you were distracted by me singing.
Ow!
Aw, man.
Yeah, hit one.
What even hit me?
Magic.
Peppy's dead. Peppy's down.
Ding a ding 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 ding. And our reward is music. I got a stereo.
I got a health extend and a checkpoint. Okay, I'm not dead. Even though I was just on death's door there, I survived.
Pretty sure the jukebox is yours. Your jukebox stereo.
Me and Slippy are gonna break through that fleet, because everyone else is down for the count. Thanks, Great Fox.
Great Fox is sending supplies.
No, it's, Great Fox will cover you.
That's what it is. Alright, well, with that, we are done for the night.
Ouch! Good job, me.
Ran a little long, but I'll take it. Especially since I was... since I missed one. So I will see you Thursday for more Gooberman. Why not?
Yay.
I will see you Thursday. And remember, winners don't lose frogs.